very short video. This is Anthony Hooper, and he was the chairman of the mediation scheme, and we all know what a palaver and thing that turned out to be, a bit of a scam, really, ran by the post office. Anyway, he's got this to say.
These were very complex and difficult cases that we were looking at and that they were looking at. Throughout the whole of the time of the mediation scheme, the post office were maintaining over and over again that the Horizon system was robust. There was nothing wrong with it. And so when you're producing a report, when you're looking at an applicant's case, it's understandable that you would want to say something about the merits. As I say in my witness statement, I tried to make it clear to Paula Vennells and to the chairman that the post office case didn't make sense. And I felt that throughout, and no doubt Second Sight did. It didn't make sense that reputable SPMs appointed by the post office after an examination of their characters would be stealing these sums of money. It didn't make sense, in particular because within a matter of days of any, quote, alleged theft, unquote, they had to balance the books. It just never made sense. I made that point over and over again.
Can you assist us with how you made that point? Was it in discussions, one-on-one discussions in groups?
Yes, yes. But it was absolutely obvious.
And who did you communicate that to?
Both Paula Vennells and I've forgotten the chairman's second name.
Was it Alice Perkins?
Yeah, that's right. Yeah. But it's why Lord Arbuthnot and the MPs got involved, because it didn't make sense.
The testimony to the inquiry by Lord Arbuthnot is also an amazing watch that you should watch, and has to be watched in its entirety. Make sure you watch it on the official IT Horizon Scandal YouTube channel, and not one of the phony baloney mass mainstream media companies that are doing exactly the same stuff with adverts. This is the official channel of the Post Office Horizon IT Inquiry, called Post Office Horizon IT Inquiry at Post Office Horizon IT Inquiry 947. And it's important to know that that you should go to this channel rather than one of the mainstream channels that are just ripping it off, really, and putting their name on it. All the mainstream media doing very little work and getting paid money for it. The nerve, the audacity, the temerity. And I do agree with Alan Bates that a lot of the post office really should just be written off and just signed over to somebody like Amazon, because the post office is really struggling to prove its existence. And at the very beginning, when we was watching Sir Anthony Hooper's testimony, saying nothing made sense about these large, vast sums of money which apparently were being stolen. It's my most commented thing, I think, on the videos that I've done, editing down the long gaps and pinning together the most important parts of witness testimony and evidence given. That the most common question is, what was the post office doing? It didn't make sense. It doesn't make sense to anybody. We've all watched, I think, at least one episode of Judge Judy, where she says, if something doesn't make sense, then it's probably not true. And all these vast amount of money that were going missing, it didn't make sense that these such suddenly trustworthy people were suddenly stealing. Anyway, I just wanted to make this very short video making that point. Alan Bates has done so much work over more than two decades. I find it really infuriating that the mass media have done so little work in supporting him and have the nerve to rip off the actual real inquiry that we are all paying for. It's a public inquiry. It's been funded by us. And yet the mainstream media think that they can just do the same exact video, no editing, no explanation, and get paid for it when they've done naff all to support this bloke. Outrageous. Thanks for watching, and it's good that you're staying interested.